Hey guys, today we're doing I'm Anime Intensity and welcome back to my channel. So we actually met two goals in the past week. Two goals, not just one. And the first goal was the obvious goal was obviously to get a new camera. So thank you to everyone that checked out my Ko-fi and Patreon. Thank you so much. So I hope you can notice a difference, not just in terms of setting. This is all that I've figured out of where I could put my tripod for now. So and the camera for now. So that's why I'm filming in this location, but I hope you can see how much sharper it is. I'm so glad to actually have a camera now instead of using my cell phone, which would say that I'm always full of storage. You know, storage is full, can't film anymore after I film 20 seconds of a video, or would just stop filming in the middle of a video, or just like corrupt the file when I check it out on the computer. Oh, your file is corrupt. Thank you, cell phone. So thank you everyone that took a chance to donate to my Ko-fi and Patreon. You guys are beyond awesome, and honestly, I would not be here with this camera if it weren't for you guys. Honestly, thank you so much. The camera that I'm actually using now is actually a Canon T6i or Canon 750D. It's the same camera, just like different region name, whatever. So I am just really happy to have a new camera, and I hope you guys stick around because our other goal that we met was the 6,000 subscriber milestone. So that's another one. Like, just give yourself a round of applause. Honestly, to hit those two goals in like around the same time means so much to me. It means so much to me. You don't get it. Like, I feel so much more motivated to make videos now that I actually have a camera that, cross my fingers, will not break on me. So you know, let's just make sure. And to not have that obstacle anymore, I just feel so motivated. I want to make videos. I want to just film for you guys. So I know today is actually really dark, and that's why I still look orange. Of course, the day that I get my camera, it's of course dark and rainy and stormy out and nasty, and I have no extra lighting. So I still have goals to get some lighting so that you know, we're not dark and orange like this. So, but honestly, 6,000 subscribers, you guys are all amazing. I absolutely love my subscribers. I love my viewers. You know, let's say you don't have a YouTube account, but you watch my videos, thank you. You share my videos, thank you. So I just really thank all of you, because without you all, you know, this channel wouldn't be where it's at right now. So thank you, thank you, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. So I didn't know what to do for a 6K celebration. I was like, live stream, Q&A, tag video, what you guys want me to do? And when I put it up on Twitter, the response was, do all three. And I'm thankful that you all want to see all those things, but I definitely can't do all those things in one day. So I think I will do the tag video for this video. Maybe I'll do a live stream some other time to celebrate. But yeah, I'm really happy to just be here today and just to announce that this channel is definitely growing. I'm going to be announcing my giveaway winner first. So let's go to the randomizer, pick a random YouTube comment, and see who has won my giveaway from last week. So let's go check that out. Congratulations! I will definitely DM you, so make sure your messages are open. I think YouTube still does messages. I hope so. So just keep your eyes open for a message, okay? Anyway, yeah, tag video. I know you guys want to do that, so let me get my stuff. I know now that I actually have a camera that films more, I actually have to make sure that I have pants on. So, and make sure that I stay in the frame. That's another thing, and it's gonna take some time to get used to, but I promise I'll get used to it eventually. So I'm actually gonna do the otaku tag. I was gonna do the anime tag, but I've done the anime tag. I've done the manga tag too, so I was like, what's left? The otaku tag. So, yeah. So there are 9 questions because the first one I've answered probably 1 million times. So I decided to start from question number 2. So question number 2 is my question number 1. So starting us off with question number 1. Manga or anime? anime. This one is really hard because I love manga. I really, really do. But I also love anime. I think it depends for the series because some series, like, you need to see animated. You need to see the action. You need to hear the voices. And some series don't need it because they're good. The way it stands by itself is okay already. Sometimes the anime builds upon that. So it's like, it depends for me. I like both. Sometimes I don't like the anime, I just like the manga. Sometimes I don't like the manga, but I love the anime. So I think it depends on the series, but in general, I think I would have to pick manga. But that's coming from a manga collector, so I'm obviously biased. Speaking of collecting, question number two, if you are a collector, what do you collect? As I stated, I collect manga. I know a lot of people have always been asking me, like, oh, make a manga collection video. I would love to do that, but my collection is so disorganized and it just bugs me so much. I'm a little bit, you know, I'm a perfectionist in that way. I'm like, I can't show it to you guys unless I organize it first, and I still have not organized it. Not because I'm lazy, but because I have no space, so everything is like scattered all over the place, and it's just like really confusing. And to make a manga collection a manga collection video just would take an extremely long time because I would have to go bearing through stuff. And it's funny because when it comes to manga, I'm like, am I collecting or am I just hoarding? What's the difference again? I don't know. I mean, my collection is my collection. It's not that great, but, you know, I love it for what it is. I also collect anime figures. I actually just started this hobby like about a year ago, so I've definitely gotten several figures, and some are, you know, scale figures, some are like tiny little things, you know. They range, when you look around, they range from, you know, small to tall. But honestly, I do love it. I love collecting anime figures, but it's something that I can't do often. I cannot do it all year. I would really have no money then. Anime figures are expensive, so I only try to get the ones that I'm really, really dying for. So, you know, I have some pre-ordered from AmiAmi. When I see the bill for that, I am screaming and I'm crying and I am leaving. I am leaving when that bill arrives. It's probably horrifying, but that shouldn't arrive for a while, so we're good. But honestly, it's an expensive hobby, but I love it. I love anime figures, and that's definitely something that I also collect. I collect anime DVDs as well, DVDs and Blu-rays. Love having physical anime in my hand, so I collect those as well, I guess. Manga, anime, and anime figures. Question number three, four, I don't even know what I'm up to. Question number three, what was your first cosplay? My first cosplay was a character from Doodarara, and it was like a closet cosplay. That's what they call it when you just grab clothes from your closet. I remember I dyed my school skirt pink because I was like, I don't have a pink skirt. I guess Amazon Prime didn't exist back then. I don't know. I had to dye the skirt. I had to like find a shirt. I had to make the beanie. I had to do like so many things and get some accessories that I got from like Payless. I threw everything together, and somehow when I went to the convention, this Doodarara cosplay group actually recognized my character. They were like, what? I was like, what? And we actually all took a picture together, so that was really fun. And I was like, wow, I did something right. But it was actually that character who was like a stalker. I forgot her name for the life of me. Wasn't it like Arisa? I think that's why I cosplayed her. I was like, Arisa, like Alyssa, oh, we were twins. She was like a stalker, and she had like the scar here, you know, like Celty. That's all I'll say because I don't want to spoil Doodarara for you. So it was a fun, comfy cosplay, and I didn't make it, but I put it all together. I don't know. Question number four, subbed or dubbed? We are in 2018. I am no longer going to have the argument of if I like, or I mean, which is better. I mean, you know, honestly, in my opinion, I will always prefer subbed anime. I live for subbed anime. I don't really watch dubbed anime, but dubbed anime is useful in its own way too. When I'm doing homework or doing something where I need to concentrate, I can put dubbed anime in the background and just listen and still do what I need to do. So it comes in handy, and that's what I do for some series because I'm like, okay, I want to watch it, but I can't focus, so I'll just put it in the background so I can still hear and do my work at the same time. So, you know, there are so many voice actors here in the United States that do put so much into their voice acting, and, you know, when I see so many comments of people bashing on them, I'm like, you know, like, they're just doing their best, okay? So, I think, you know, overall, it's definitely got to be subbed for me. There's a lot of dubs out there that I'm like, I will not touch. Like, I, no. But I am not at the stage of being an anime fan where it's like, dub sucks! Like, no. I've moved past that for a while now. It's been quite some years. I know some people still think like that, but I have moved on. Now I'm just like, you like dubs? Cool. Cool. You know, I like subs. You like dubs? Cool. You know, so that's how it is now. Number five, name an anime that made you cry. Honestly, I have a heart of steel. No, heart of stone. Sorry. I don't really cry for anything. The only thing that I think I felt like a tear, like on the side, like it just a tiny tear, I felt it, maybe a little bit more of a tear, it was actually for A Silent Voice. I felt that. I definitely felt that. Honestly, A Silent Voice just really just hit me in the feels. It was so good, the emotions and everything. Listen, when you see people get bullied, you're already like, stop it, you know, stop it. But then she's deaf to top it off. She's deaf and is getting bullied. Like, what? Oh my. It was like a roller coaster, that movie. I was happy, I was sad, I was happy again, and I was sad. So it's like, it's a film that has so many emotions. And it's fantastic because of that. I absolutely loved it, but wow. Wow. I felt it. Let's bring on a happy question. That's it. What's the happy question? Oh, this is a happy question. If you had to marry an anime character, who would you marry? This is a very happy question. I like this. Honestly, there are many good husbando material types, and I think I have quite a fair amount of husbandos, but there are a lot of husbandos that I wouldn't want to marry. Like Izaya from Durarara, I would definitely consider him to be a husbando, but would I marry him? No. Same thing as, you know, Aomine from Kuroko no Basuke. I love Aomine. He's definitely husbando, but would I marry him? Definitely not. Whoa. Honestly, like, it just wouldn't work out. So, I don't know. I always say that I would love to marry Edward Elric. You know, after that time skip, I was like, huh. So, I would always say Edward Elric. But I also really, really love Joseph Joestar. I think Joseph Joestar is perfect. I think he's kind, he's precious, he's funny, he's everything that, you know, it's just... all the good qualities in somebody is in Joseph Joestar. So you know what? I'll marry Joseph Joestar. I am totally okay with that. Like, I think life would be very fun. You know, it would be really exciting. So I think that sounds like a great, you know, we would make a great team. I think. Question number seven. Are you part of an otaku pack or are you a lone otaku? I am. I wouldn't consider myself to be part of a pack. Like, what pack? Maybe the pack is my subscribers? Are you guys my pack? I don't know. But I don't... you know, I wouldn't consider myself to be a lone otaku. Because I have all of you. So I guess I'm part of a pack, I guess. Question number eight. If you could live in any anime world, which world would you live in? I would like to live in My Hero Academia. I don't know about you, but that sounds really fun. But I would want, like, a really cool quirk. Or maybe I just wouldn't have one. I'll just be, like, one of those... people, the sidelines being like, yeah, All Might, you know, like, woohoo, like, you know, I'd just be like number one fangirl, like, or something like that. But honestly, like, I would like to have a quirk and live in My Hero Academia and test out for the, you know, to go to UA and do all that fun stuff. You know, aside from the danger, it actually sounds like a lot of fun. Maybe I wouldn't go to UA, I would go to another school, so I wouldn't be the prime target. But I think it would sound really fun to just live in the My Hero Academia world. I don't see why it wouldn't be fun. I mean, aside from the obvious danger, but it sounds like a blast. And last but not least, if you could have any anime power, which power would you like to have? I don't know. I was gonna say something from My Hero Academia, but I don't really think that I have like an absolute favorite. I think the most functional, though, would be, like, Todoroki, because you're fire and ice. Like, yeah, like, that sounds cool. I would like a quirk like that, because I've always wanted, like, a fire element, because then you could cook your food wherever you are. You know, you're just, like, and, like, heat up your food. So I know that's not what anybody would use it for, but I would use it for that, okay? So I think that's really functional. And ice, too. Ice could be functional, too. You need a cooler. Hey, guess what? I can freeze your drinks for you. So... I don't know, but I think I would definitely pick something like that. So I know I'm really corny, like everything that I say is really dorky and dweeby, so that's just how I am. And if you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. I definitely get way dorkier, so yeah. Anyway, that was my tag video for my 6k celebration. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it was filmed well and not blurry, because I don't know how to control this camera yet, so I'll see you in a moment. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Totally, totally appreciate it. Please like, share, or subscribe if you like this video, and I will see you guys next time.